Phil Redmond, you've done a few things in TV. Oh, yeah. You're here, back in Liverpool, where you belong. What's going on tonight?
Well, I think... yeah, I am. And then one of the things we're doing tonight is Lord Putnam's chairing this commission looking at whether television adequately represents the people. You know? I think he's doing a kind of national tour, going around talking to people and get canvassing opinions, all that kind of stuff. And so finally he's ended up as at the centre of the cultural universe, you know, to hear the truth.
The truth. What is the truth about TV today and local in a sentence or two? Where is TV today? Are you still as excited by it when you got in? Because you were writing scripts for, was it Tommy Cooper? Was it?
Not Tommy.
How did you kick off?
No, Harry Secombe.
Harry Secombe, yes.
Bernie Winters and all that.
Yeah. I mean, well, there was excitement back then.
Oh, it was
breaking
it,
in.
It was brilliant. It was a new medium. It was opportunity for people with new ideas and new ways of doing things and everything. And what television's done now has gone into another period of atrophication where, you know, it's just the same old stuff. What it needs is another injection of new talent, you know, not hidebound by tradition or, you know, sort of, dare I say it, the Oxbridge gang, you know. Mm.
How do we get that? I mean, is local TV the answer? Could it be?
It can't be. I mean, we thought we had the answer here to do just a pure public service channel, you know, but the intellectuals in London couldn't get their heads around it, so they gave it to you guys, you know, to struggle on, you know. And it's a struggle because the transmitter pattern in the UK goes back to the 1920s, and because of that, you know, the transmitters have to be quite high power or very small power. So you never have either the locality or the critical mass to really make a difference, you know. So it's always fiddling around the edges and tweaking and things. And I've had the view, I've tried to change it, you know, over 30 years in the game, you know, but it always ends up always funneling back to London all the time. So.
In a perfect world, which hopefully we're heading to sometime, what would local TV be? How would you set it out?
You just give it to the people. I mean, all you do is you have the technical ability to actually put people's ideas on screen, and you just say to them, what do you want to put on? And then you put it on, and the audience vote. You can either do it by text these days or use the off button. But, you know, sooner or later, you'd find the level. And it's a bit, the model's there. It's BBC local radio, you know. And you find that some of the most vibrant parts of radio are in BBC local radio, and Radio Merseyside here is held up as the best local radio station in the country, and that's because it's so open and they have things like the A-Team and stuff like that. So that's the model, you know, and that's what you do. But to do that, you have to break away from this transmitter control problem, and anybody could be on air tomorrow for about £25,000. You can buy a transmitter for about £20,000 now, and you could be on air, but of course you wouldn't get the license for the frequency.
Do you have the patience left to carry on working in TV? Do you want to carry on? What is the future holding for Phil?
Well, I've gone back to the first core principles of being a writer, so I'm just sort of doing novels now, and I describe them as a Brookside on imprint, you know, and I can rant and rage about the life there and throw in a bit of a murder and chaos and things and all that. So, you know, and I don't have to sit every time I write something, I don't have to then compose the letter of explanation to a TV regulator.
Phil, it's a delight, as it has been, watching your programs down the years. Please come back. We need you.
Okay.